We're going to dive into the Calvin cycle. So we're looking at photosynthesis and all the parts and pieces that allow a plant to take sunlight and breathe in CO2 and water and make glucose or sugar out of that. So if you haven't seen the previous videos, photosynthesis overview and ATP ADP, you may want to check those out. But the Calvin cycle gets a little bit more involved, mainly because I'm going to take it one step further in the chemistry with this whole thing. Now, the photosynthesis overview, I've got this on other videos. You may want to check that out. Again, we're just going to focus in on that area of the Calvin cycle and what happens to finally produce this glucose at the end of the process. The Calvin cycle is not an organelle inside of there, so I'm just representing it as a cycle because you're going to see that it cycles. So here's how we're going to look at this to begin with. Inside the chloroplast, you have this 5-carbon chain. Now, it's not just carbons. There's a whole bunch of other stuff with this, all right? But we're just representing it with those carbon nuclei to keep things as simple as possible. So you got this 5-carbon chain. It's a molecule, and it's got a really big name. You can look it up if you want it, but I'm not going to share all that technical stuff here. It's just a little bit overwhelming when you're learning the process. Now, this is where a cell needs to breathe in CO2. When it breathes in that CO2, it undergoes another chemical reaction that breaks the carbon off, and then that oxygen goes away and gets used in other things. So we're not going to follow the oxygen right now. We're going to follow that carbon. As part of the Calvin cycle, when that gets broken off of there, it gets attached to those 5 other carbons. Now we've got a 6-carbon chain. That's important, all right? We're going to see a 6-carbon chain later on, but this is a different one. This is not really one that our body can use to make sugar. A few things have to happen first. So if we go back to the photo part of photosynthesis, where we made ATP, that ATP, as part of the Calvin cycle, it releases that energy. So that phosphate group breaks off of there. When that phosphate group breaks off, it pours out its energy, and that energy slams into our 6-carbon chain. But it's not quite enough. There's a little slight configuration chain. It's not enough to get the full reaction to happen that we need to have happen, which is why the plant also needs NADPH. Okay? Again, trying to stay away from getting too technical, but this NADPH has got those 2 electrons. When those electrons break off, it releases energy into this cycle, and we're left with NADP+. Now remember, the NADP+ is like the wagon that you're carrying along, but it doesn't have anything in the wagon. It's just something that can store that energy. You might have to go all the way back to the photosynthesis overview if you don't understand what that is about. So now this 6-carbon chain has been hammered, bam, bam, hit by 2 different sources of energy. When that happens, it breaks it apart. It breaks it into 2 3-carbon chains. There is other stuff attached to all of this carbon, just not showing that. 3 of those leave the cycle. They're just going to wait. Now, this is happening really fast, but those are just going to wait. The other 3 stay in the cycle. They're going to be recycled, and they're going to be used again to make the next step. So this 3-carbon chain that's still in the Calvin cycle, it's going to get hit with the energy from ATP one more time. ATP comes in, bam, it releases that phosphate, that energy slams into this 3-carbon chain, and then there's 2 other carbon, another 2-carbon chain floating around. So you just have to trust me on the fact that these are in there. They have complex names, but those are in there. That energy, so to attach those on to the other 3 carbons, requires energy. ATP provides that energy, and all of a sudden, bam, once that energy is released, it allows those to attach on there. Now we have a 5-carbon chain again. Well, that's what we started with. So all we've done here is we've taken that 3-carbon chain has turned into a 5-carbon chain, and that's what we started with when that plant breathed in the CO2. So this happens again. More CO2 comes in. It gets broken apart. The carbon gets broken off and gets hooked onto that 5-carbon chain, making a 6-carbon chain. And then ATP comes in and slams into that and releases its energy. NADPH comes in. The electrons break off. It releases its energy. And this thing breaks apart again. And all of a sudden, down here at the end of the Calvin cycle, we've gone through the Calvin cycle 1 time, 2 times, we've got 2 to three carbon chains. Those two, three carbon chains get attached together and they make another six carbon chain. What's that six carbon molecule? Well, that's what we've been working with the whole time, or trying to get to the whole time. This is the product of all of the steps of photosynthesis. We've just made sugar, C6H12O6. That C6 means six carbons. And remember, there's some hydrogens hanging off of there. There's some oxygens hanging off of there. That's how we get that whole configuration. But this is the sugar that plants make. I've got the complete reaction down there at the bottom. Requires three CO2 molecules, requires six NADPHs that break off those electrons. We need five waters, although for some reason that H got really small. That should be five H2O with a big H, little 2O. We need nine ATPs, that's our source of energy. And when all that comes together, boom, we end up with sugar. We end up with some other stuff as well, which is why I have the little star by the sugar. But what we're really trying to focus on here are the steps of photosynthesis, going from sunlight, water, and CO2, and finally ending up with sugar at the end. Now, if you go back to the overview of photosynthesis, you know that a plant actually takes that sugar and converts it into a number of other things. Here's the overview. We got to that last step down there at the bottom, making glucose. And again, there are videos explaining the other steps if you need them. I've also got a little handout for this one, a worksheet that I use in my class to explain what happens at each of the steps, a good overview, and a good sort of quick assessment to see how well you understand what's happening in all of these things. And I do have that attached down at the bottom. You can go to the link. Also, there'll be a little link here at the end when that pops up. Again, we created our sugar at the end through all of these processes. And you're going to see, if you miss some of those other videos, they're going to show up all around here somewhere on this page. And then we'll move into the next step, which is cellular respiration. Cellular respiration is what happens when you or an animal goes and eats that plant and gets the glucose out of there. That glucose goes into your body and it makes energy. So that's the next step. Good luck. Keep on learning.